In this video lecture, we're going to focus on cyclogenesis, or the development of the mid-latitude cyclone. The first stage of cyclogenesis is the stationary stage. The stationary stage, you have a stationary front. Neither air mass is strong enough to outdo the other air mass. So we have cold air here, warm air here. They are butting heads. They do not move very much, if at all. The next stage, we take this stationary front and we start to insert a low pressure over the top of it. It begins to spin the air. Therefore, we get a cold front to the west of the low and a warm front to the east of the low. And we call this the wave stage. Again, the first stage is a stationary stage. Then when we insert the low pressure, which starts the spinning, we start to sort out the air masses. We get warm from the south, and we get cold from the north. The third stage is the mature stage of cyclogenesis. It is called the open stage. And again, it is the mature stage. Here, we get the warm front that really doesn't move very much from the wave stage. And then, because the cold air behind the cold front is very dense and heavy and moves quickly because of that, the cold front then starts to shift more to the southeast into the sector of warmth, into the warm sector of the mid-latitude cyclone. That is the open stage. It is also here that we start to develop severe weather. The fourth stage of cyclogenesis is the occluded stage. Here we have the cold air mass is moving abruptly into removing the warm air. So as the warm air is being removed by the cold air, we get an occluded front, which indicates that the warm air is being removed. You get a warm front that's still remaining there. The cold front is pushing the warm air out of the way. Because the cold air is heavier than the warm air, it is pushing right in over the top of it. That is why we have an occluded front. Severe weather continues in this phase, or this stage, of cyclogenesis. Eventually, we get to the fifth stage of cyclogenesis is the dissipation. And if you were following along and thinking, okay, what's going to happen with this stage, we totally remove the warm air from this system. And it starts to fall apart. So we get a cold front and an occluded front. No warm front because the system has removed the warm air out of it. So the important aspect of cyclogenesis is the fact that you have to have both warm and cold air for it to work. When the cold air removes the warm air, the system falls apart. Now this basically begins, cyclogenesis begins on the east side of the Rocky Mountains and also in a small way, east side of the Appalachian Mountains. The stages of cyclogenesis continue throughout the rest of the world and they keep re-evolving. So we get the stationary stage first, we get the wave stage, the open stage, the occluded stage, the dissipation stage, and then it starts all over again with the stationary stage, the wave stage, open, occluded, dissipation. Again, stationary, wave, open, occluded, stationary. And it continues this way. This is how the weather evolves within the westerlies throughout the rest of the world.